हर वीक दो रेस्टोरेंट खुले थे लाहौर के अंदर. जब भी किसी ने रेस्टोरेंट खोलना है आई थिंक इट इज़ बेस्ट टू रन इट फॉर टू मंथ्स. आई थिंक फॉर अस a better location is Johor Town. I think for a setup like ours you need at least 12 to 15 million as a startup capital. The reason why McDonald's became what McDonald's is now is because it works on a standardization model. It does not work on people.
So let's just get right into it. Muiz is our Muiz is an entrepreneur and he runs a restaurant called Baranh in Lahore, which is famous for its tawa chicken. So let's just start with asking Muiz, ki Muiz, what do you do? How did you get into this business? And tell us a little bit about your business and its origin and your origin, or let's just take it from there.
So basically, it's an idea between that we started, or me and my partner, who's actually based in the old city. So the idea comes from that, and since understanding the history of Lahore, we knew that Lahore is encompassed by 12 gates, and every gate has its own speciality in terms of the food and culture.
So how did the idea of Baranh came about? Like, why did you think of starting it? What made you start the company, and what was the reason behind it?
Okay, so Baranh was a new idea, but me and my partner Zain, we've been wanting to get into the restaurant business for almost 5 years now. Initially, we just wanted to start off from the fence, trying to cater to the wider public. Tab mara harisa karne ka mood tha. That is something which was not available in the fence, but it didn't really work out. So Baranh started off formally when me and Zain sat down that okay, we have a concept now. And since Zain was particularly working with RF Chitkhara, he was running their outsourced franchises, so he had a good experience with how the recipe and how the food would work out. So that was one dish that we could start off with, but we realized that since it's a proper restaurant, we cannot bank on one dish. We could make that one dish our main significant item, but since Baranh was a bigger concept, we could cater to the wider menu. So that is how Baranh came into existence.
Right. Okay. And so, what's running the most? Like, what's the most popular dish in your menu?
We don't have a very very big menu, like I told you. So it's a small menu, and the whole idea is to make customer experience maximum part of the menu. So yeah, tawa chicken works. Our gulati kebabs are very famous. We introduced them recently. In winters, our fish is very good. Our mutton kadai is very good, because we hand pick our products, we hand pick our purchases ourselves, and we make sure the quality is not compromised. So whatever little that we offer, we make sure it's of very good quality and taste.
Right. Okay. So you did not have any experience in restaurant business before that.
Not at all.
So what kind of obstacles did you face initially?
We're still facing those, since it's a desi genre of business. We cannot. The chef dependency always exists. No matter how much we try to quantify our ingredients, at the end of the day, we are at the mercy of the chefs. That is one thing that we face on a daily basis, and with that, a lot of other things come into play. You can't move the chefs; they have to be there, because once a hand changes, that means the taste would also change. So we've been very very particular about the chefs, and in the last almost year and a half, we've been in operation for the last 14 months. We have zero turnover in terms of chefs. So yeah, that is one obstacle that we face. The dishes can never be quantified unless we learn it ourselves, which we are doing. So if the chef's not there, we can make the dishes ourselves. So that was one obstacle. Marketing is another, then finances.
What about the operations? Like, how do you store the food? The food has to be fresh. What do you face with that?
And how? Okay, so when we started, we knew that there was a pilferage in this business, and with pilferage came the idea of storage, and then how do you make your back end so strong. So what we decided on doing from the very first day was not to do a storage at all. So whatever we buy on a daily basis, that gets consumed at the end of the day. So whatever little that is left, it is given to the staff. So every day we buy new products. So we have two purchases running back and forth to the market, buying products on a daily basis, which are very fresh. So, and one thing I would like to tell you that we are the only restaurant who does not use any food preservatives. So we don't store our food overnight. Unless two or three items which need to be marinated, which are mutton chops and barbecue items, which are required to be marinated overnight. Everything else, it's bought on a daily basis.
Okay. Why did you choose Desi cuisine? Did you do any research before that kis kisam ki cheezein chalti hain, kya nahin chalta aur kya result aaya uska?
Okay, so jab humne shuru kiya 2018 ki June mein, bahut zyada restaurants khul rahe the. Restaurants mein khayal hai har week do restaurants khul rahe the Lahore ke andar. वो खुलने की हद तक ही खुल रहे थे लेकिन लोग ये रियलाइज नहीं कर रहे थे द मैसिव टेस्ट पैलेट दैट एग्जिस्ट फॉर द देसी कैटेगरी ऑफ फूड एंड सिंस वी आर वर्किंग इन लाहौर वी नीड टू रियलाइज एंड वी नीड टू अप्रिशिएट व्हाट द कस्टमर्स यूजुअली गो फॉर वेरी फ्यू पीपल गो फॉर सुशी आई मीन यू वुड लाइक सुशी और कॉन्टिनेंटल फूड इट इज़ आउट देयर But it is not a volume-centric business. So for us, we needed something which would appeal to the masses, and masses would always go for something which is, you know, which they would have it in their houses. And when I believe Desi was something which would appeal to everyone.
Right.
You don't really need any specialization for a Desi taste palette. So yeah.
And it worked.
Yeah, Alhamdulillah.
कौन से आपके months हैं? जहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा बिजनेस हो रहा होता है या कौन सा टाइम है जहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा बिजनेस हो रहा होता है और कौन से हैं जहाँ पे सबसे कम बिजनेस हो रहा होता है
ओके सिंस वी आर देसी रेस्टोरेंट विच इज़ प्राइमरली बेस्ड ऑन आउटडोर सेटिंग सो फॉर अस विंटर्स आर ग्रेट रमज़ान पीरियड इज़ द बेस्ट बट मानसून सीजन इट मिसेस अस अप कम्प्लीटली बिकॉज A very small seating indoors, 25 people. They don't get accommodated indoors. So and plus the major issue is our kitchen is live, so which is outside. So so yeah, winters is very good for us. Ramadan is very good for us. I think 6 to 7 months, spring winter is good. Summers tend to be a little difficult because people don't like to sit outside. Although people still do come. But it's not the best. I mean, it's not even close to the experience you'd get in winters.
Are you able to break even in those months, in the difficult months?
Yes, we do. We are. I think we have losses in 2 months. I mean, we don't have a lot to compare our figures with. We've been in operation only for 14 months. I think last year in this month we incurred a loss.
Okay.
This month we didn't, so obviously it's growing every month. The whole idea of a business is to make it sustainable and continuous. What people think about restaurant business is you make money hand in hand every month. It doesn't work like that. It's a year-long business, so you need to work on averages. So if you're making a lot of money in 1 month, you need to apportion it for the months where you don't make a lot of money.
You were talking about the location. How important is the location, and how well has it worked out for you? Gaddafi Stadium is the location,
yeah,
right?
So when we were about to start the business, we had this location as one of the options, and I met a lot of agencies regarding the sort of branding that we wanted, regarding the sort of brand outfit that we wanted, but Gaddafi was a major drawback. Because we wanted to cater to the upper niche, people who haven't been to Gaddafi before, because our market was those particular clients, and Gaddafi was a major hurdle for that. So we had to align our marketing in a way that Gaddafi was something which is very secondary. Like if you talk about any other restaurant, it is identifiable by their location. We probably are the only restaurant in that vicinity which is identifiable by our own brand. Like you talk about other brands like Butt Kadai, it is identifiable to Gaddafi. Like Deira, it is identifiable to Gaddafi. For example, any restaurant that has gone out of Gaddafi, they haven't been successful at all, even though they've been in business for the last decade and a half. But with us, I think we haven't catered to the volume that comes to that particular market. We have our own clientele. So yeah, Gaddafi in terms for us worked out only on the basis of its proximity to MM Alam or Main Boulevard, but nothing else. because our marketing was a little different from the other brands that were doing their business in that vicinity.
So if you were to change the location, where would you think the ideal location would be?
Change the location or a new location?
Find a new location or, you know, relocate the...
Okay, so there are two things about it. Normally what people do is people go for flashy places. Like they would want to open in Y block, phase 5, but you need to see the business potential in those areas. I think for us, a better location is Johor Town.
Okay.
Because it's a massively, highly, densely populated area, and there is a lot of customer awareness in terms of our cuisine there. So we have a lot of customers coming from that vicinity, and I think if we open in Jordan, it's going to be a good response.
How are you measuring ke kahan se log aa rahe hain?
Okay, so I think we are one of the very few restaurants in Pakistan who manage the social media ourselves. We don't have any third party doing it for us.
Okay.
So my number is on the page right now. So if you call, the restaurant's going to ring my phone. So since you're so close to the customers, you keep a tab on where they're coming from. And I think in my experience in the last 14 months, a lot of people have come from that part of the city.
Okay.
So that is how we gauge that we'd be doing better operation in that part of the city.
Where do you find the chefs? How do you find them? How do you procure them? And how do you retain them?
Okay, so like I told you, my partner Zain is based in the old city, and since he had this experience before we opened this restaurant, he was working with Al Chitkhar, and he had this. He knew what goes into making these recipes, and he was working closely with those chefs. So it was easier for us to bring in chefs from the old city, because our taste is not the Desi commercial taste. It is the taste of the old city. And since he lived there, it was easier for him. That is one thing that he looks after.
Okay.
So I'm not even allowed to go in the kitchen, because those chefs have to be very, very differently treated. Let us put it that way. Like, you can't be, if they make a mistake, you need to let go quite often, and you need to be very benevolent with them. So yeah, that is the reason why we've been able to retain them. Otherwise, it becomes very difficult.
Acha, okay.
So if our chefs go, we pay them like twice more than any other restaurant pays to the Desi chefs. I mean, Desi chef in a restaurant, the head chef, there's one head chef. So our cuisine, every dish has its own head chef. So we're paying almost 4 times more than any other Desi restaurants in our kitchen. So yeah, that is one thing that keeps them retained.
Okay. You were talking about bylaws, and since it's Gaddafi, so PCBK, you were telling me.
So yeah, our indoor falls under PCB, that is governed by the federal government. Our front end falls under the Punjab government. So our restaurant is shuffled between the federal and the Punjab government. So at times we have to face bylaws of the federation. At times we need to face bylaws of the provincial government. So it becomes very difficult, because some laws that are prevalent in the provincial government are not prevalent in the federation. So it becomes a little difficult working in a way that both the part of the governments are satisfied.
How much capital did you invest, and when did you break even?
Okay, so one is the capital investment, and the other is the operational investment. What a lot of people have done wrong with this business is they plan their initial capital investment and they don't have money to run their operations, because like I told you initially, we were very lucky that we started working from the very first day, because we opened in that specific part of the year where we knew a lot of people would go out and have food like Ramzan. So even though we weren't making a lot of money in that particular part of the year, first year, but we made sure a lot of customers came in and have our experience, because we knew getting a lot of people inside would take a lot of time, and that would mean putting money inside in the business again and again. So but generally speaking, I think there's one capital that you need to start the business, and then there's another to run it. I think for a setup like ours, you need at least 12 to 15 million as a startup capital, like to start the business. And I think you should still have at least 5 million to run it throughout the year. So 17 to 20 million is the sort of money you should have when you want to open a serious Desi restaurant. That means that even if you don't work out for 6 months, you still have money in your pocket to run your operations. Okay. Because once you start taking money out from the business and start to run the business from that specific little sale that you have, then you tend to let go on a lot of things that you might want to do initially. So 17 to 20 million is the sort of money that you should have.
Okay, and when did you break even?
We were able to break even by the 11th or the 12th month.
That's not bad.
It's not bad because we were lucky that we didn't have to invest a lot of money again and again in the business. So our startup capital was the money that we had to recover.
Achha, so uske baad you didn't have to invest back into the business. Achha, interesting. So now it's just the profit. Now it's only
almost,
the profit.
Almost, okay. Like I told you, there are months where you have to incur loss. 2 months we made a loss. There are months where you make losses. But I think, like I told you, this is not the business that you, like you were just saying, that we make profit, that we start making profit now. If we do it that way, yeah, we'll be making profit every month. But then again, you need to look out for the months which are dry. Mm. So most of the profit that we'd be taking out now, we try to keep it inside the business.
Okay.
Because we want to go on an expansion mode. We've taken money out from the business in a way that we want to reinvest it in the business.
Okay. Are you thinking of scaling now?
Yeah.
Okay. And when do you think scaling is a good idea? At what point do you think?
Okay. So we had people coming in and asking for franchises from almost the 6th month of our operation.
Okay.
But I think we were wise enough not to do it. Because once we had done it just for the sake of money, we would have lost our grip on the actual soul of the business, which is the back end kitchen. I think one thing that we've been able to achieve is the food consistency over 14 months, which is very difficult for a Desi restaurant. And we were able to do it just because we weren't focused on a lot of other things. We were just focused on one branch. I think for a restaurant to start franchising out, it shouldn't be before a year and a half. Okay. Unless you have all your SOPs in line, unless you have your kitchen in line, mm-hmm. you shouldn't franchise it at all. You'd have a lot of people coming in asking for your franchise, offering you good money, but I think in the longer run that actually hurts you. I know about restaurants who did 5 franchises, 6 franchises in a span of 2 years, mm. but it all just trickled down. It didn't really work out for them.
And the reason is that they lose because the consistency?
Because their own SOPs were in line. They were just doing it for the sake of money.
Quality gir jati hai.
Quality gir jati. Kitchen pe control nahi rehta. Ab jaise hamara apna staff hai. Now that we know that we have to franchise, we've been training additional chefs in-house for the last 2 months now. Say for example, even if we don't open for 4 months, we'd be paying more to those additional chefs. Just so when we do, we just have to move them from one premises to another.
Mm.
But they don't have to get trained on that particular branch from scratch.
Mm.
But that is one thing a lot of people don't see.
Mm.
You need to invest on the chefs, you need to invest on the system before you start expanding.
Because I have also noticed that a lot, because whenever we go to a restaurant or uski kisi ek branch mein jate hain, one branch is better than the other. So people are not able to figure out ki kis tarah se, you know, uski quality ko maintain kar saken aur usme consistency bhi ho aur wo
asal mein hamare liye franchise ka franchise dene ka SOP thoda sa mukhtalif hai. Wo is tarah se ki main to bada strictly ek cheez pe convinced ho ke kehta hu ki agar kisi ne franchise leni hai usne usi tarah se time lagana jis tarah se humne lagaya. Because if he doesn't understand the kitchen, if he doesn't understand the front-end operations, I think our biggest critique initially were the customers, and I think those were the biggest help to us. Like I'm telling you, I take reservations myself, I manage complaint myself, we reply to the social media complaints ourselves just so we know what part of the business we're lacking in. Unless the franchisee is there himself, observing every customer, observing the kitchen, they can't do a very, very good, very good operation. They can't do it the way the company would. The company has a lot on stake. Like for example, we would have a lot on stake, more than money. We would have our human hours, we would have our efforts, the time before the restaurant was set up, our branding, our brand image. A lot goes into us giving off a franchise, while people just feel it. It's just a financial transaction, while it's not. A lot is coming from the company. Like for example, if we give out our franchise, the SOP that we're developing now is that our kitchen staff would come from us, and they don't need to hire anyone else. Yeah. So they just have to manage the front end of the business, which means they have to be there on the premises to do it. Otherwise, it becomes very difficult. That is the reason why you see people just invest in the business, the franchise just invest in the business, hoping that they would just make this much amount of money every month, and they don't even have to go there. It doesn't work like that. It would, but obviously there would be a massive difference between the company and the franchise. But for that, the franchisee has to take the same amount of ownership as the company would. Mm. Unless they don't do it, it doesn't work out.
How do you think McDonald's did it?
Okay, so McDonald's was a very different business. McDonald's initially worked for almost 12 to 13 years on their own SOPs. McDonald's is the sort of business which works only on standardization. The sort of Big Mac that you would have from, say, Link Road McDonald's would be the same, would have the same taste that you would have in High Street Kensington in London. Mm. So they worked on standardization. Like I'm telling you, it's not a very very short-term process. It takes a lot of time. They are not chef dependent. They are not people dependent. And I think the reason why McDonald's became what McDonald's is now is because it works on a standardization model. It does not work on people. So any restaurant that works on similar SOPs, it could grow the way McDonald's did. But our business is a little different. We are a Desi restaurant. If we work, if we are a fast food chain, we could go in the direction of McDonald's, like a lot of restaurants are doing in Pakistan now, that they are working on standardization, which supersedes everything else. It supersedes the amount of money that you're making initially, because you're working on a vision. McDonald's is not just a business, it's a vision. So in order to work towards it, you need to work the way they did. So investing 12 to 13 years just on their operations, working on one single branch. I think it was in Maryland. I'm not sure where that was, but they worked on one branch for a longer period of time. And their SOPs was food on the table within 5 to 7 minutes.
Yes.
So if any restaurant works on that SOP, I think they would do what McDonald's did.
Right.
But then again, you need to invest a lot of time.
Mm. Acha, how did you get the initial attention? How did you gain the attention? How did you create the brand awareness initially when nobody knew about you, when you were starting off?
Okay, initially when we were starting off, first 20 days, this was before Ramzan, we had people coming and tasting our food. And we were very open to criticism, because those 20 days, I think we had almost 1500 people coming in. Like a batch of 100, 120 people would come in daily, on a daily basis, try our food. And I think that was, that cost us a lot of money, because we weren't charging them anything. And that spread the word out. And every customer, say for example, if you would come one day, you tell us that, okay, your mutton kadai would work better if you add more black pepper in it. So next day we would try it that way. We had tawa chicken made in desi ghee, sesame seed oil, desi murghi. So many varieties of food made customers engage with us more. And I think by the time we were planning to launch, a lot of people had already eaten, and they had posted about our food themselves without even us asking about it. So this was in June 2018, and I think at that point no one was doing free food tasting at that big of a scale. People would do it, but just on a one day basis. But we would do it on a daily basis for almost 20 days. So I think that took the word out initially, and then our prices were very economical. The sort of food that you would find in Old City, we were pricing it on that same price giving it in the heart of Lahore and in a better hygienic environment.
Did you also engage any PR company with you?
We did ourselves.
Nothing. Any social media marketing?
No one. We didn't work with anyone. We had hired a graphic designer for almost 2 months, and I think that was only for 2 months.
Okay.
So no PR company, no agency, we did it ourselves.
So this is all word of mouth?
All word of mouth. Total organic. We are only restaurant in Lahore which hasn't invested a dollar in their Facebook. So if you scroll through our page, you won't find any sponsored ad. Although a lot of people disagree with this strategy, and I think there's no way better to do business than do it organically.
Okay.
It takes time, but I think at the end of the day, if you become impatient in business, it doesn't work out.
So अभी जो आपका जो जो 5-6 महीने हैं जो कि जहाँ पे थोड़ा इन्फ्लक्स कम होता है उसको आप कवर किस तरह से करेंगे? आर यू जो स्केलिंग ऑफ द बिजनेस है इज़ दैट गोइंग टू कवर इट या आप उसी लोकेशन जो प्राइमरी लोकेशन है उसी में ही आप कोई और स्ट्रेटजीज अपनी चेंज करेंगे टू कवर द लॉस?
अच्छा, जैसे मैं बता रहा हूँ अभी हमें इतना ज़्यादा टाइम हुआ नहीं है, तो इस दफ़ा हमने जो लास्ट ये चीज़ एक्सपीरियंस की थी वो हमने इस दफ़ा ख़त्म करने की कोशिश की है. जैसे वी आर वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट विद आवर मेन्यू, वी वांट प्लेइंग एट ऑल. सो दिस टाइम ऑफ द ईयर वी स्टार्ट इंट्रोड्यूसिंग न्यू डिशेज, लाइक वी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड सजी which we hadn't done in the last 12-13 months. So that engages customers more. Plus, I think this part of the year gives us time to work on our operations, work on our kitchen more. And like I'm saying, we want to expand. So in these months, we focus on that part of the business. We're looking at spaces. We're trying to train our staff. We're trying to train our back end kitchen. We're trying to get our store intact. Stuff like that. So it still keeps us busy, but not necessarily customer-centric busy, our own business-centric busy.
Okay. So initially when you started the business, आपने कुछ figure out किया था कि हमारा unique selling point क्या होगा?
हमारा unique selling point ये था कि हम लोग लाहौर के उन हिस्सों से वो dishes लेकर हैं लाहौर के heart में जो लोगों के लिए accessible नहीं है. जैसे अगर आपने से फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल अगर आपने अच्छी सज्जी खानी है तो आपको अंदरून या हीरा टाइप जगह पे जाना पड़ेगा और अपनी गाड़ी में बैठ के खाना पड़ेगा. हमें इस सज्जी पे ऑलमोस्ट 20-30 डेज लगे हैं इसको बनाने के लिए जिस स्टेज पे ये आज पहुंची है. सो आई थिंक आर यूनिक सेलिंग पॉइंट वाज मेकिंग द अंदरून की डिशेज एक्सेसिबल टू पीपल इन द हार्ट ऑफ द सिटी. दैट इज़ आर मेन सेलिंग पॉइंट.
क्या प्रॉब्लम्स आई थी शुरू में? इज़ देयर एनीथिंग दैट यू वुड लाइक टू शेयर जो कि इफ़ एनीवन हु इज़ गेटिंग इनटू द रेस्टोरेंट बिजनेस शुड नो एंड दे कैन डू देयर होमवर्क बिफोर?
सबसे पहले तो प्रॉब्लम ये थी जो मैं स्टाफ डिपेंडेंसी और किचन डिपेंडेंसी. जब भी किसी ने रेस्टोरेंट खोलना है, आई थिंक इट इज़ बेस्ट टू रन इट फॉर 2 मंथ्स बिफोर यू ओपन इट फॉर कस्टमर्स. टेस्ट रन करते जाएँ, इट विल हेल्प यू इन द फ्यूचर. आपका बैक एंड किचन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. लोग उसको अंडरमाइन करके मार्केटिंग पर फोकस करते हैं, क्योंकि आई थिंक लोग इस बिज़नेस में आते ज़रा ज़्यादा उसकी फ्लैशीनेस की वजह से हैं. काफ़ी ज़्यादा लोग खोल लेते हैं रेस्टोरेंट के, यार हमने एक रेस्टोरेंट खोल दिया, बट आई थिंक इट इफ़ यू टेक इट on a serious scale, it could be very beneficial. It's very lucrative as well, but you need to understand that this business wants you to be on your toes 24/7. And on your toes 24/7 does not mean on an average scale. It should be on your ultimate best performance every day. So I think in order to achieve it, you need to test run the restaurant for at least 2 months. That is one thing that we had to do over time. Like in Ramzan, our system sort of crashes because we have almost 80 to 90 people on a waiting daily, iftari and sehri. So we can't manage them effectively or the way we should be managing them, just because we did not have a test run before we had launched the restaurant. In terms of the front end kitchen, front end of the business, we had managed the kitchen, our dishes were going to the customers timely, but our front end got compromised. So I think first you need to gauge the sort of number that you want to deal with every day. Like, we market ourselves in a way that we do not want to serve more than 100 people on a daily basis. By But if it goes to 150, now I'm talking about period which is not Ramzan. So if it goes more than 150, our system crashes because we, like I said, we procure on a daily basis. There's a limit to what we can store in that particular period. So yeah, test run is one thing. Second is to hire a good accountant. Accountant who has an experience in terms of purchases. We found a guy with that relevant experience after 6 months. So we had to do this exercise initially ourselves for the first 6 months. So I think if you were able to find someone who do accounts, who could manage purchases for you, and keep it different from operations, this should be one autonomous part of the business. And if you don't find someone to do it, you can do it yourself. So if it's a small business, the owner can do the accounts and the purchasing himself. Hire a good professional manager, and I think the outlook of the manager should reflect the outlook of your brand. If you want to cater to the masses, to the public, undermining your own quality of the brand, then you can hire any XYZ. But if you want to stand out in terms of your brand image, you need to hire someone who exhibits that by his own presence. So the manager, the main GM of the restaurant, should exhibit the persona of your brand. And if you don't do it, then it just, you know, trickles down. It becomes bure se bura hota jata hai, staff niche se niche. So agar aap acche logon ko hire karenge, to aapka brand ki outlook bhi achhi jayegi.
Sahi. You said ke your limit is 100 people a day. Agar usse zyada
at a time.
So agar usse zyada,
so then we have reservations. So people who want to come, like 20 to 30 people in a group, they call us beforehand. We give them the slot where we know that our restaurant is not that busy.
Okay, but let's say walk-ins come, they don't reserve. What do you do with them?
We make them wait.
Okay.
That does not happen a lot because, like I said, people get engaged with us via our social media pages, so we know the time and the slots when the restaurant is very busy. So we try to give them the slots where we know the restaurant won't be that busy.
But do you communicate them
beforehand? Yes, we do.
What are the challenges in terms of I don't know, the quality managing authorities like PFA or other authorities?
Okay, so we had an incident recently as well. So right now, the 16% that the restaurant charge, it has to go to the government. Our issue was the tax consultant that we were working with could not really identify between the NTN and the STN number. And since this was something which we had no knowledge of, it affected us as well. We had PRA coming to our premises telling us that you should be doing it this way. And I think but there was a communication gap. PRA is a very good organization.
What does it stand for?
Punjab Revenue Authority, and that is what the restaurants come under. So one is the Food Authority, one is the Punjab Revenue Authority. Punjab Revenue Authority becomes more important to you because you're charging taxes on their behalf.
Okay.
So since your job is just as a collecting agency for them, you need to work very closely with them. Something that we discovered very recently, we weren't coordinating with them. So it is always good to pay them a visit once a month. But they are very accommodating. Even though we weren't really coordinating with them, once we had started, the gap does not exist anymore. So I think for a restaurant, getting familiar with PRA, it is extremely important. Because once you start charging taxes, or even if you don't charge taxes, you're still liable to pay. Even if it does not show to the customer, it is still the bylaw of the government that you have to pay taxes. I think a lot of new restaurants wouldn't know about it. So before you start your operations, it's always suggested that you go and pay them a visit. Their staff is very cooperative, and the Food Authority. For the Food Authority, you need to have your medicals done, you need to follow their SOP. They're also very accommodating, but the whole idea is that you need to realize that your business is not working in an isolation. Your business is working within the paraphernalia of the government. So since it comes under these two particular institutions, it's always good to go and pay them a visit. Even if the bylaws are a lot for you to understand, they may specify down the bylaws which are very important for you to follow. So those two authorities, they are within the city, they're not too far away. Just go there, meet them, tell them that you want to open a restaurant. They're going to tell you the sort of bylaws that you'll be following very strictly. So I think if you do it beforehand, it becomes very easy. And don't hire a tech consultant. We did it like all other restaurants. And I think it makes the gap even more, because as a business owner, you'd be more appreciated going to the authorities rather than a tech consultant who's obviously working with a lot of other brands as well. So, yeah. And doing your taxes yourself, it's not that difficult. As long as you want to do it.
Do you need to hire a lawyer at some point?
If you want to do dodgy stuff, yes. Which a lot of restaurants do, but...
What kind of dodgy stuff?
Like, if you want to conceal your sales, if you don't want to show the actual numbers. But I think with the new government, a lot of people don't want to do it anymore. The old practices are fading away. So, lawyer is when you want someone to fight for you when you're treated illegally. So I think these two authorities won't treat you legally unless there's an unforeseen circumstances.
Right.
But generally, you don't need a lawyer on your
payroll.
There's
no need in the initial.
You can hire a tax consultant if you want to, but lawyer is not really needed.
Okay. Right.
But your own accountant can do your taxes mm-hmm. for you, so mm-hmm. not necessarily a third.
So a good accountant is very necessary.
Very important.
Very important.
It may cost the business initially, but I think in the longer run, it pays off.
Is there anything else that you think new businesses should know before starting?
Pay scales of the staff, I think.
Okay.
Like, we have the misfortune of paying a lot of money to the chefs. Arab aadat pad gayi hai, so we can't do anything about it. I think initially you should understand the sort of pay scale that you should be having your chefs on and your front end. I think it's always good to pay more to one person who could, you know, shadow you in a way that he could implement the SOPs the way you would want to implement. So if that person does it for you, you can pay him a lot of money. Like, not a lot of money, you can pay him above average, but the other staff should be in line with the market. And it's better to find someone who's experienced in the sort of genre that you want to operate in. Like for Desi, you shouldn't be working with someone who has an experience with Chinese. I'm talking about the front end, order taker, staff. And those are very important. We may feel that it's just a 20,000 a month employee. But if you see, he is the interface of your brand dealing with the customers. So that person is very important. And it's always best that you hire the staff yourself. And since there's a lot of unemployment. Mm. You just have to put it out there and people would come in asking for interviews. So don't let anyone hire for you. Mm. Don't let the manager hire for you. You should hire your staff yourself, even if it's the smallest paid employee. Everyone in the restaurant premises, you should hire yourself. In a way, you should understand that when you're not there, he's representing your brand. Mm. It's very important.
Have you taken a day off ever since you started your business?
A couple, but not a lot. This business, this retail and service business requires you to be on your toes all the time. And even if you have a day off, you still need to remotely manage the restaurant.
So when your business takes off and it gets into running for the next 5 or 6 years, how do you think, are you going to make it automated enough that you can take a vacation or something?
That's what we're working on the days when, or the months when we don't have a lot of customers coming in. We use it to automate our systems. We use it to manage the systems more effectively. And since we have time to invest at the moment, we do it as much as we can. But now we've started delegating a lot of things that we were doing a year ago. We're asking our managers to do it for us now. So as soon as you delegate and you monitor the delegation process yourself. It's not just a task that you give to your managers over the phone. You need to see how they're performing after you've delegated a task. And if you're not observing them yourself, they won't be able to deliver the way you would want them to deliver. They may be bad, they may be good, but there's a way you would want the business to run. And I think if you're there to oversee the process, that helps you a lot. So you should oversee the tasks that you delegate to your employees.
So there's no other way around.
There's no other way around. Mm-hmm. This business requires you to invest time. And I think if you manage your time effectively, like, don't just be in the restaurant just for the sake of it. If you're there, just make your time count. As an owner, you should make your time count. Socializing is one part of the business. It should be there, but then again, if you're on your business premises, it should be directly or indirectly linked with business.
Right. Okay. We wish you all the best for your business.
Thank you.
we love your tawa chicken.
पैसे के बात के क्रिकेट कौन पैसे देता है और वो गलत नहीं कह रहे थे क्रिकेट कौन पैसे देता है अली ने साउथ पंजाब की फ्रेंचाइज ले ली थी नहीं होता आई वांट टू स्टार्ट माय ओन बिजनेस ड्रीम एंड इट्स द बेस्ट थिंग एवर वो बड़ी जल्दी टूट गई थी एंड एनीबडी आई वुड मीट आई वुड लाइक कभी भी ना करना अपने साथ मेरा एजेंडा सिर्फ था कि मैंने एक बहुत फन कॉलेज जाना है और उन्होंने बिजली की तार पकड़ ली और बस मैं आपको